Well, what a year it has been for kaiju fans around the world. Shortly after Godzilla vs. Kong, the much-awaited series came out, Godzilla Singular Point. And man, what a series. To see how Godzilla evolves throughout the show is just mind-blowing. Welcome to Discover, folks, and let's start. A mythical beast whose existence was prophesied to bring about a global cataclysm when the seas were stained with red, Godzilla made his first appearance in the episode Tigerish. From there, Godzilla rapidly developed through four different forms, beginning with Godzilla Aquatilus, Godzilla Amphibia, Godzilla Terrestrius, and finally, Godzilla Ultima. In this video, we will provide an explanation of all four forms of Godzilla. First form. In the year 2030, Godzilla Aquatilus was first discovered by the crew of a submarine 900 meters beneath the sea. Godzilla Aquatilus was detected moving swiftly on the radar, stalking the crew slowly. His first form, Godzilla Aquatilus, has an elongated marine reptile physiology with traits similar to whales and mosasaurs, such as Mosasaurus and Tylosaurus, as well as Titanosaurus. He has red-violet scales and orange tail fins, while his back has orange stripes and its underside has a pale yellow ridged plating. He has large dorsal spines that run to his tail. The spines vary from jagged with vein-like structures to curved and conical as they go along. The creature also has four large webbed flipper-like legs with large claws. Second form. Godzilla Aquatilus made landfall in Tokyo, engaging in a brief struggle with one of the Manda. After killing it, he took on a second transitional form, better suited to terrestrial environments, i.e. Godzilla Amphibia. Godzilla Amphibia strongly resembles Varan when crossed with Godzilla. In this form, his tail now has three barbs instead of a splayed fin, while his hind legs are smaller than his forelegs. His feet are flat and spread apart. His head strongly resembles Varan's, while a row of Godzilla-esque dorsal fins are carried over his Aquatilus form, though are framed with Varan-esque spikes on the neck and tail. Like Varan, his quadrupedal and plantigrade body mirrors the structure found in terrestrial reptiles, such as iguanas, tuataras, and monitor lizards. Similarly, his back is covered in a knobby-scaled carapace, with these scales also running along his limbs, with his underbelly being smoothly textured. Third form. The JSDF bombed Godzilla in his cocoon-like state. The shell started to fall apart as a new form of Godzilla emerged, Godzilla Terrestrius. Godzilla Terrestrius begins to resemble a traditional Godzilla with the features of a Gorosaurus. He has teal skin with a yellow underbelly, an elongated face with a large lower jaw, and eyes set very forward on his skull, close to his snout. Starting from this state, he becomes bipedal and adopts a more grounded theropod-like stance, hunched forward rather than standing directly upright. He has traits of theropods such as Allosaurus and Carcharodontosaurus. Fourth form. Godzilla Terrestrius continued his rampage throughout Tokyo when he was briefly intercepted by a large black rodent, which he instantly shot down with an atomic breath ring. That night, the JSDF ordered a bombing run which briefly brought the kaiju down, only for him to evolve once more into Godzilla Ultima and get back on his feet. As his fourth and primary form, Godzilla Ultima harkens back to the early Showa era, featuring a more monstrous version of his terrestrial form, a deep charcoal coloration and white dorsal plates. The design also features an array of jagged teeth. The creature also has multiple osteoderm-like structures on his neck and forearms, similar to those found on crocodilians. Well, that's it for today, guys. Remember, don't forget to subscribe to the channel for more amazing content.